India finished the day on 290 for 9. Impressive bowling effort from England.
It was. We put ourselves in a great position to have them probably all out for 220. A little bit frustrating that they've got up to 290. But you know, if you look at the big picture, we seem to be taking the poles of the batting of the order. We've just got to figure a way to get a tail out.
Wickets for Stuart Broad and Jimmy Anderson again. Broad picking up his 250th Test wicket. Some effort from both of those guys.
It is. Jimmy and Broadie have been fantastic performers. For Broadie to get his 250th and then Jimmy to be the leading wicket taker at Lords in the same game is quite special. They've proven, you know, how good a bowling unit they are for England, and hopefully many more.
You picked up the wicket of Pujara with one that nips back. You must have been pleased with that one.
Yeah, that was in the middle of a good spell there. It was good to get some luck and eventually get a wicket.
What did you make of the track out there? There was a lot of talk before the game, but how did it play?
Obviously, you know, it's quite a green pitch on top. It's nice to see the ball flying through, a bit different to Trent Bridge. The ball was swinging, so I think, you know, we made the right choice in winning the toss and bowling.
Where do you see the state of the game now? Obviously, Rahane's 100 put the dents on England's wicket taking, but it's still wide open.
Hopefully we can go up tomorrow and take this last wicket sooner rather than later. And then, you know, hopefully the batsmen can really pile it on. I think it's one of them wickets where it's a struggle to start with, but then once you're in, you get the pace of the pitch and, you can really go big, as Rahane showed.
Just a final one on your own personal bowling form. How do you feel that you're going at the moment out there?
Today, you know, I was in the ball a couple of good spells. The ball's coming out nicely, bit of swing, so pretty happy with the way today went.